everybody. It's Billy, the Crafty Floridian. Have y'all forgotten my name already? I'm sorry, I have been out of commission for quite a while now. Still not feeling really well. I'm having some issues with these horrible headaches. I guess the last time I saw you guys was that Friday night live with Billy and friends. And I can't remember. I don't think I've been on since then. I did go and have an MRI done. And the results were nothing is significant. Is not significant, but the other stuff she'll explain to me at our next appointment, which is, I think it's September the 9th. God, I can't believe September, it feels like the whole month of August is almost gone. So anyway, I just want to let you know, so I went and had the MRI done, and then my friend across the hall that took me, we went to the Dutchman, it's an Amish restaurant, and only the Amish people work there. And we went and had lunch there. And when I was walking out, all of a sudden, I kept losing my breath. I'd take a couple steps, and I just couldn't get my breath. And so we finally got home, and I still could not get my breath. So I waited a couple days, and then I started getting a headache, this headache that just encompassed the whole top of my head down into my spine, and it just felt like it was just going to blow. But yet, when I was at rest, it didn't bother me, and I've been nauseous, and my new favorite room in the house is the bathroom. I've been spending a lot of time in there, so I've been having some issues there, and I still have those issues. Now, the headache is not so much at the top of my head, it's down into the base of my head. So I called my neurologist, and she took me off of the medication that she was giving me for the TN. And I thought maybe it was the medication that was causing all this, and so did she. So, but they took me off of it like cold turkey, you know. So I'm off of that medication, and now I'm still having issues. And then I thought, now she was giving me through Friday, which was, yesterday, to get off the medication. And then I thought, you know, because of the reaction was within an hour after the MRI, I was wondering if the contrast stuff might have caused the nausea, the headache, and, you know, all that stuff. So I'm going to present that to her. It was either that, or she thought maybe I had COVID. Well, I've had my shots. I had no sign of a fever. I took my fever all the time. I didn't have one of those things that you put on your finger for your blood gases, you know, to see where your oxygen level is. Blood gases. What am I, a nurse? I don't think so. But you know, one of those things they put on your finger. But I am going to order one. I haven't done that yet either. So needless to say, here I am. Last night I finally ordered some food from Walmart. And, I did take a shower day before yesterday. It felt good. It had been a while. Because when you're sick and you are unsteady, you just don't want to get in the shower when when you're by yourself. So then I took a shower, and that made me feel better. And then I changed the sheets on my bed, and that took about 2 hours. So I felt good, and I changed the pillowcases on the couch, so where I lay down during the day. So anyway, so here I am, and I just wanted to get on, first of all, to thank everybody for your emails and your concern and your messages. I do appreciate it. And I wanted to answer them all, but I just, it's so hard for me to talk, without getting emotional, because I've been feeling not well for quite a while. So anyway, so I'm just taking one day at a time. And Monday I will get in touch. I get in touch with my normal doctor. And she and I can go over. I think I have an appointment with her soon. So, and I got to get my NRI done, which measures what's happening, with the Coumadin that I take. Because I haven't had it done since I was in the hospital on the, 17th and 18th, I think it was. So anyway, that's an update. We don't want to talk about ills anymore. I'm going to try to do a few things here just to get everybody kind of caught up to what I've tried to do. I haven't done very much. I haven't done any sewing because it seems like moving my head or trying to reach down or something seems to bring it on, and it hurts. It just hurts. And sometimes all of a sudden it doesn't hurt, but it hurts like all the time. Especially when I move my head or keep my head up. So eventually I do a lot of laying around. I've been watching a lot of YouTube. Just different things. I've watched some sewing, making some sewing stuff, some crocheting. I watched Chevy. She was with Christy Glass. That was very good. It was an interview. I enjoyed that. I laughed and had a good time. So that sort of took me out. That took me to another place for an hour or almost an hour. And that was really good. So go on Christy Glass and you'll see the interview with Chevy Rell. And it was in her stuff room. And she goes through all of her stuff. And you'll see a bag that I made for her. And she says that was by Billie. And my Dammit doll that I made her. She mentioned that I had made that for. So it was really cute, and it was, it's like Chevy's like a diamond in the rough, or a rough in the diamond. What, I don't know how you want to call it. I don't know how to exactly say it, but I just love her to death. I just love her to death. So I really enjoyed that show, and I enjoy all the beautiful, knitting that she does, and Christy Glass, I watch her. I have been watching her also, but yesterday I saw where she had finished a sweater that her daughter had started, and it was beautiful. It was sort of a raglan. It was really real, supposed to be like for a beginner even. So it was really pretty. The yarn was just gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So anyway, so I've been catching up on. Oh, and I like the Posh Paper Lady. I think that's her name. Anyway, she takes like mats from the dollar store made tote. I guess I told you about her before, but I've been watching other things that she's been making out of the dollar. Dollar Tree. So I've been catching up on a lot of stuff, and well, not catching up, but I mean, looking at podcasters that I must have subscribed to a long time ago, and I never just kept up with them, and now I'm trying to catch up with what's going on. And Alaskan Crafty Gal. Victoria, I guess, because I know she's going to change her name eventually, but how she took those scraps and made a bag out of it, and to tell you the truth, I have a whole bunch of scraps already cut that I was going to experiment with sewing them together and stuff. And I watched her technique and I thought, oh, I can't wait to, you know, be able to hold my head up long enough to do something like that. So I'm really excited about, you know, doing some other things. And then, of course, I watched Debbie from Canadian Crocheter. I'm mentioning all these people, but y'all know, you go and watch them because they're really interesting. And she had also has worked with some scraps and making stuff. So I thought that was really interesting. And she said that she needed, she had, I guess she got in touch with a friend or something and sent her some scraps. I'm going, I got a house full of scraps, Debbie. You didn't ask me. I would have sent you a box of it, baby. But anyway, now that I know, if she, you know, wants to continue with scrapping something, I'd be happy to send her lots of scraps. I mean, I got a huge tote. It's so hard to throw the scraps out because you think of things that you can make, but you just don't get around to it. So I think that's going to be fun. So I can't wait to get into that. So I've also been getting emails from people that have received some of the items that they won at the Christmas Live. And I thought that was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed doing that. So maybe I'll do another one and have a different, you know, another different group of gals on. But that could be way in the future. I got to get myself well enough to get moving around. I got stuff to do, and I haven't got time to mess around with this pills and MRIs and C scans and all that stuff. So anyway, let's get down to the nitty gritty now. I did finish a couple objects. I did. First, I finished the... Why does my brain not want to catch that? I did finish the poncho for Laura, the Mad Mimi. There's these little bugs are all over the place. They're in the hallway, they're out by the door. And every time you open the door, they come in and they just bug them. They bug me. Let's keep it that way. So here's the poncho. Isn't it a beautiful color? So I'm going to let me find the front and I'll slip it on and show you what it looks like. It's going to be really warm for her, I think. For the hockey game. All right, I'm going to stand up if I can. So you can see it. Okay. Let's get that belly. So here's the poncho. And I had these big buttons that were given to me. And so it goes all the way down. And some nice back to it. Because she's not as big as I am. So it'll fall, you know, very nicely. But these buttons I'd had, someone sent them to me. I can't even remember. I think it was Debbie from Canadian Crocheter sent them to me. But I have kept them. Now, the collar on this, on the pattern, is a lot longer. And it, you know, it'll roll over and, you know, lay it down. But I talked to Laura and I said, what do you think? Because I didn't want her to have so much around her face. She doesn't like a lot around your face. So I just stopped it here and I thought, man, that's perfect for me. So it would have to be perfect for her. And she's the same height as I am. She's 5'6". So I'm a little over 5'6", but I think she'll do fine with this. So I enjoyed making it. And what did I do with the pattern? I'll show you the pattern. It's by Yarn Inspirations. It's called the Tweed Under Wraps Poncho. And that's the, well, I guess you can see that, right? That's the poncho. And as you can see, the collar is much wider, but I shortened that a little bit. But yeah, so, and you have to determine how many yards you're going to need and all that good stuff by I changed some stuff around with the gauging. It's a 5-weight. The yarn that I used was a 5-weight. It was Willow, which was by Hirschner. It's got a little bit of wool, like 25 wool, the rest acrylic, and it is so soft. And I got, the skeins were $2, $1.99, I think, a skein. And I got a whole bunch so I could make some other stuff with it, too. But it is so soft. I really like this. So now that I've shown you, I can get this in the mail because she needs it for September, which is coming up. But yeah, it turned out really nice. I enjoyed making it. I enjoy making things for other people. I don't make anything for myself because I really don't need anything. And I'm in Florida, so I don't need all this stuff. So let me put that over here. So yeah, so I got that finished. And I've made this twice. And the other was for a girlfriend in Virginia that I made it for. And she uses it, you know, on cold winter days to walk her dog and stuff like that. So, yeah. So that's yarn's inspiration, if you're asking. Because I'm not very good at linking things in the bottom. So, if you want to make a poncho for outside, for walking your dog, for the winter, that's a great poncho. It's easy. It's simple. The pattern is easy to read. All that good stuff. Excuse me. Now, the next thing that I made, and it took me about 2 weeks because I work on it a little bit and then I get out of breath. I couldn't hold my head up and then I go lay down again. But this wonderful lady, Billy. I got the thing right here. Chronically crocheting. She sent me the Mr. Persalot. She sent me the whole kit. She sent me the yarn. She even did the eyes for me. She the safety eyes. The fleece, she fixed that all. She had it all in a package for me to do. And the yarn for the ears and all that stuff. And I'm not a real big Amy kind of gal. But I do enjoy doing them when I do them. Excuse me. And anyway, I had fun making her. And here she is. Isn't she cute? She's a little Persalot, and I really enjoyed making her. There's my hair intertwined. Now, I think that is, no, maybe that's not mine. But here she is, and here's her little tail. I tacked her tail on so it wouldn't be flopping around. And, you know, with my own cat, I would hate to have my own cat. Because she found something the other day, and she started playing with it, so I have to watch her. But anyway, so I haven't got a name for her yet. If you can think of a good name, let me know and we'll call her that. I'm going to keep her, I believe, for myself. I usually don't, but I think I would like to keep her because she's so cute. So this is my Persalot that I finished. Yep, very easy to follow. She even included a hairpin. A bobby pin for to use for marking your rounds. I didn't use it. I usually use a different color string of yarn, and I usually just you know, a long string, and then I just sort of move it up as I go. But because I know that Donna Wolf, she uses a bobby pin, or she used to. I don't know if she still does or not. So anyway, so that's Persolite. I don't have a name for her, but she is cute, isn't she? I just love her. And I measured everything with, I could say, come here, Rosie. I got to mail you, got to measure your tail. So I crochet so much because she has a big, long, fluffy tail. So I'd measure her tail, and then I'd measure this one. And I wanted it to come around into the front. So I made it a little longer than what the pattern calls for. But because I wanted, I have a painting up here that I did. Let me see if I can swing it. I don't know which way to swing it. That's not it. Let's see. Keep swinging, Billy. There. You see this picture right? You see the painting on the far left there? Well, that's a picture of Samantha, my cat. And see her tail wrapped all the way around the front. So I've always thought that they look cute when they have it like that. So that's why I put her tail so it's all around in the front. So yeah, so this is Mr. Persolite. And that's, and this is the yarn that she sent me, and I just love it. Thank you so, so much. I really enjoyed doing this. It was a perfect, perfect timing for me too. Laying back and doing it. I just enjoyed it so much. And this is her pattern. And I'm sure if you go on Chronically Crocheting, you'll find where to find her pattern. I'm sorry, I wasn't more. Oh, it's not even written on her pattern. Lots of, let me see. She gives you she tells you everything, how to make it, where to put it, to sew it on. Chronically Crocheting. It's the sole property of Chronically Crocheting. And that's her channel. So do check her out because that it was so much fun to do. And I think a kid would just love something like that. It's just, or even an adult, right? A big girl like me. So I thought that was really exciting. So I love that. Maribel, I do have your gift here in the box ready to mail that, but I haven't mailed anything, honey. Everybody's just going to have to be patient. As soon as I feel a little better, get better breathing, better, you know, just feeling better all around, then we'll get some of this stuff out. But I haven't mailed it. The other two things is, I got this flamingo was won by Bobby Allison. Here's the flamingo. And there's, I even attached a hook, my favorite hook, whatever that hook is. I'm sorry. My brain dead. See what happens when you stay away too long. But I haven't heard from Bobby Allison. If you send me your address, I'll put this in the mail to you. And then this is the other unclaimed one. And I went back and had to. And this was won by Vicky G. I don't think it's Vicky G. I'm not sure. There's a couple of Vicky. There's my Nighthawk Vicky G. And then there's a Vicky G. So if you go back and look at, well, anyway, she won this this beautiful Christmas do-rag. So I know who it is, and if you send me your address, I'd be happy to send it to you. So those are only two that were not claimed. So I'd be happy. I got them. I haven't done anything with them, but I will if you don't claim them. You know me. So that is there. I don't know if I wanted to show you. Excuse me, I'm talking away from you, and I'm sorry. I did Lynette from Charm Grandma. Charm Grandma. Lynette. Yeah. I think that's it. Anyway, she's collecting washcloths for Rose Likes Crochet. So I got out some of my old cotton, and I made, that's blown out, isn't it? Let's see. There. So I made this washcloth. Now, this, I call this the backwards single crochet. Y'all can call it whatever you want, but that's what that edging is. And then I made this this pink one. Isn't that pretty? And then I was going with this one way, and then I changed my mind right in the middle. So I figured this will give you texture, and then this is the smooth part. And that's another one that's being washed out. There we go. And I made this one. This is I Can't Believe It's Cotton by Hobby Lobby. And it's great for, it's very soft, and it's great for washcloth. And then this one I made. I just make up the pattern as I go along. So I'm going to send these to Lynette. I wish there was more, and there probably might be more later on if you need them. But I wanted to get these in the mail. I got some hats for Creations by Jax is collecting hats, or is promoting to make hats to send to Lion Brand for Hate Not Hats. You know what I'm talking about. Okay. So anyway, so I did do those. And then I got this request to make these do-rags. And I got the fabric in, and I'm just loving this fabric. And I don't know, I probably shouldn't show you. I don't know if the person watches my channel. Oh, I won't show you. I better not show you. Yeah, I better not show you, because I don't want to get in trouble. Okay, so we'll put those over there. Then, Michelle Chapone, I don't want to leave it there, but Michelle Chapone sent me some beautiful blankets for the babies in the reservation. And I think what I'll do, I don't want to bend down, so I'm just going to pull one out at a time. But this matches my outfit. Isn't this pretty? This is a beautiful pink and purple blanket. Isn't that pretty? I mean, they're just gorgeous. It's so soft. This is very soft. I love this. I think it's that DK. I'm looking at, I think it's DK, that DK, DK, whatever. Well, anyway, I think it's this one. And then she made this one. Isn't that pretty? Isn't that gorgeous? I love that. I love that pattern. And there's more. This one is my fave. I love this one. See how she's done the border? Isn't that pretty? And then it has a... Isn't that gorgeous? I just love this. I love the border and everything. It's just so pretty. I just love this, Michelle. Thank you so much. I've got... Well, that's an empty box there, but underneath I've been putting everything in there, and there, another box in the other room where I've got hats for those kids. And I think we've got one more. We've got this one. Aren't they pretty? This would be great for a boy. Yeah, so she saw the boys and the girls. So, and this is a great stash buster, too, if you want to take your stash and just make some blankets. So, these are from Michelle. Thank you so much, Michelle. And I did get some nice cards, get well cards, and, you know, miss seeing you and all that. And thank you so much. They're in the other room. I've been hanging them out, you know, place them out so I can enjoy them myself. So I didn't bring those in with me. So I apologize to everybody that, I did get some requests that people wanted Dammit Dolls, and they want to know how to get them. Well, I make the Dammit Dolls, and then I show you on the video here, and then you can decide if you see one that you like, you let me know, or you see one, you know, the material that you like, or whatever, you let me know. And I make them as I, you know, it's something that I can just whip up the seams and take it in the other room and stuff it and all that stuff in there and put their, you know, do the hair in there. So I do have some dolls that were unclaimed and some Christmas dolls that I didn't get around to. So I have this one if anybody's interested. This is a snowman. This is red. Boy, is it getting blown out. It's probably because it's getting cloudy. We're due to have lots of rain in the next 2 or 3 days from this tropical storm Fred. So Fred's coming for a visit. But anyway, so here's this is the snowman. See the little snowman. And that's a Christmas one. And here's another Christmas one. She has long red pony pigtails, and she's also the snowman on this one, green and snow. And then I have this one, which is it's got the heart and the scope on it that I think is really cute, and I put this grayish hair on it. Because, why did I put grayish hair on it? Because, you know, if you were getting it for a nurse or a doctor, sometimes they could be a little older or whatever. So, that one. Then I have this one. This is a Christmas one, and it has a little Santa boot on it. A little Christmas boot. Then I have this green one. It's got a messed up jivey hair. Pretty green one. Then I have the rainbow one. She cute. This is the rainbow. And you don't have to leave these on when you give them to people, but it's just, you know, but that's, I think this rainbow one is cute. Then I have the dogs, the pretty dolls, and with the little pink ponytails. So I have that one. And then these two don't have hair yet, but they are stuffed. But I never got around to finishing the hair part. And they're Christmas ones. Both of these are Christmas ones. So, I do have some dolls. If you see one that you like, just email me. And I'll invoice you. And then when you pay, then I will ship them out to you. That's the way it works. If anybody is interested. So, we put all these babies back. I like this one with the snowman and the birds, and cardinals and owls on it. So, yeah, let's see. I think that's really all that I have to show you today. I do have some, Reggie, if you're watching, those are the, And to send your doll, it probably wouldn't be that much. So if you see a doll that you like, I will be making some more, you know, as we go along. Or if there's a certain material that you saw that you liked, I can do that. A larger bag. I got larger bags to make. Let's see what else I got going on. Just looking at my... I think that's about it that I got to show you. That's all, folks. So anyway, I'm going to go and lay my head down for a little while. Yeah, it doesn't hurt as bad as I thought it would be. And it's really cloudy now, and it's going to start. It looks maybe it has already started raining. Yeah, I see sprinkling. I have to be careful because I got water intrusion in here. Right there in my window, which this backs up to. So when the rain starts, I try to pull everything away from the window and line it with a beach towel or something. So I have that problem that I'm trying to get some answers to, or I will report it to HUD and everybody else, because I'm tired of it. So, yeah, don't mess with old people, you know. Just don't mess with old people. That's my saying. I watched Mama Swift today. I'm telling you, she does some awesome blankets. I don't know if any of you guys have watched Mama Swift, but she crochets some beautiful blankets. And I don't know if y'all realize this, but she'll see a pattern somewhere. And like, she saw a pattern for a washcloth. So she took that pattern and made it into a blanket. So she's very inventive and very creative. And she could take something and make, she could take nothing and make something out of it. So she's just, has a beautiful creative mind. And she loves doing blankets and shawls. She does shawls also. So she's the queen. She's a queen with that. And so anyway, I enjoyed her video today. I'm getting a little, I don't know. I've been watching so many movies. I'm rewatching movies that I thought I hadn't seen, and I get halfway through and I know the ending to this. And then I go on and on and on. So that's what I've been doing. Just resting and I love to get some answers on why all this started and what's happening and all that good stuff. I'm sure there's an answer somewhere. Might not ever know, but we'll see. So that's it. The TN, I tell you though, that medication that she gave me made me feel no pain anywhere in my body. Because when I started going through withdrawals of that medication, all the pains in my legs and my back and everywhere started jumping up in front of me. And I went, oh no. But, you have to take the good with the bad, right? So it was just crazy. There's another lady. There's some sad stories right now, and it's very, very sad. It just seems all of a sudden our community is being hit with people that are ill or passed away. We even had a lady that was relatively young. She was maybe 58 or something, 59, upstairs, and she died in her sleep while I was in the hospital, actually. And they had a memorial service for on the 10th of August, but of course I didn't go. So anyway, it was, you just don't know anymore. So, and then I've got the vacation coming up in October, and I'm really looking forward to that. I think it's going to be a ball. We're going to do a mystery dinner night. And I am going to be a tarot card reader, like a gypsy. And, well, my name is Madame Flemme La Bouche. So I'm going to be reading tarot cards. So I'm really excited about that. So it's going to be a good time, and I'm really, really, really looking forward to it. So I'm going to shut up, and I'm going to go back and lay down, and I will see you guys soon, I hope. I've got so many projects in the motion. They're not in the motion, but they're in progress. Whips. Oh God, Billy. Oh, I hit my head if it didn't hurt. Whips. I got so many whips, and I do have this one whip, and I had bought this special linen yarn for. It was very expensive, and it's a beautiful sweater. So I might just pull that out because it's something I don't have to really think real hard on. I did start this one thing. Nicole from Zoom and I were making this bag, and it's a lot of chains and stuff. And for some reason, it hurt my head to work on it because I had to follow the chart, and my vision is a little blurred. So I'm having trouble reading the chart. And then I had to go and count little chains, and oh geez, it was a mess. So I haven't worked on it. It's not a mess, but I mean, I haven't worked on it, and I don't want to show you until I at least get one side finished. So anyway, that's it. So I'm gonna hit the pike here, and I'll talk to you side. Please don't worry about me. I'm gonna be fine. Really, I'm going to be fine. I've just been really sick, and I just, to a point that I didn't move from one room to the other without, you know, hitting the throne. So just take one day at a time, and I'll see you guys soon. And, keep hooking. Keep hooking or knitting or DIYs. Just keep doing it, baby. Keep doing it. Sewing. Just keep sewing. Doing all that good stuff. So I will talk to you guys later. Have a great weekend. And we're going to be in rain zone this weekend. Starting now, I guess it's really getting real cloudy there. Or maybe we'll skip all the rain altogether. But the only thing they're really warning us about is flood zones. So flooding is the biggest thing. So anyway, have a great weekend. It's good to talk to you guys. I've missed you. And just take care.